swear to me, you are gonna see a million. We got the Congo long, just like the Amazon. Split big like a cylinder, man, I'll be like God.
So, here we go. Back with this. I touched on it before, but now I'm going to touch on it again, but go a little bit more in depth with it. You know, this whole 4B movement bullshit, it came from Korea, of course, and it's basically their way, modern feminist women's way of shutting shit down from men, paraphrasing. But I'm going to let Philip Scott rap a taste on it a little bit, and then I'm going to come back and give my thesis on it, my final thoughts, and we out. So without further ado, please go to Philip Scott's channel, subscribe to the brother. He's doing amazing, great things. Much love and respect. If you haven't already, please go to my channel, The King's Table. Subscribe, like, comment, and share. I greatly appreciate it. I'm your boy, Big Truck. So without further ado, let's get to work.
Well, the women are saying in South Korea, we're not going to marry men, date them, you know, have, you know, intimate relations with them at all. We're just going to leave them, you know, completely alone. We're going to do our own thing. And as you do more research into it, a lot of Western women have jumped on this, but even Korean women have come out and said, wait a minute, hold on. Not all of us are into that.
And here we go.
And let's go ahead and check out what our sister says about it, because she said it makes a lot of sense.
So we already let the white women.
Before the sister begins to share her thoughts on it, we all know that that shit ain't gonna last. And the only ones that's really, really pushing this fake ass movement is modern feminist my buckets. Traditional women that stand on tradition, that stand on business, that stand on integrity, that stand on 50-50 teamwork, that stands on happiness and nurturing and loving, they're not for this shit either. They're not a part of that. Because a large number of those women are happy. Brother on their arm, no brother on your arm.
Man is always the prize. Remember that. They try to say happy wife, happy life. A happy man is God's plan.
Reach it, Brother Teddy. You are a godsend.
So, and for all the brothers who's watching this, you got to always make sure you go where you celebrate it, not tolerate it, right?
Convince us to kick out the black fathers, and we didn't need black men with the feminist movement. And now this 4B movement, we got to let these women from Korea convince us to not create families in a black community. And I'm seeing women, I just did my research. I saw a few videos and I see women talking about, I've been on a 4B movement. I'm on a 4C, D, E, F. We don't need these men. We got to strategize. We got to get strategic about how these men are about to come after us. Y'all been talking about decentering men. Like, y'all got to wake up. This is not beneficial to us. If y'all think the strategy is getting rid of men, not having families, not having babies, that's going to be a lonely, lonely life. All it is a way to keep you single and by yourself. And that is not a healthy, happy, fulfilling life to be by yourself. Who wants to be by yourself? Like, seriously. I know we talk about I'm single by choice. Okay, for now.
This, but you don't want to be the type of woman that man is looking for. That's a problem. And it's going to continue to be a problem as long as you keep the attitude that you have now.
Sisterhood is too damn busy turning on each other. Everything that this sister said, she was spot on. No lie detected. And that is the truth. I got my job. I got my education. That's good for you. But those things don't teach you how to keep a man. I'm single by choice. Motherfucker, you are not single by choice. Either A, you fucked up the relationship, or B, he fucked up the relationship. At the end of the day, somebody fucked up the relationship, and that's why you're single. Stop it.
Make me sick. No, I'm sick of my man. Let me tell you something. I'm telling you this. That's it, what you're scared to say. I can tell you.
And that's the whole thing of us men coming up with the drizzle drizzle and twizzle twizzle movement. Because the very exact same thing or tools that a large number of modern feminist women use on men, we just flipping it back on y'all asses. And what was made for fun and jokes, y'all in y'all feelings, y'all butt hurt, y'all frustrated, y'all angry, y'all big mad. That really, really shows your fucking character. It really shows your character, how you really, truly behave. But it also shows how stupid and unrealistic y'all asses sound when you hear men say the exact thing that y'all asses say.
Celebrate it, you gotta celebrate yourself, right? How you think creates how you feel becomes an emotion, that emotion becomes a vibration, that vibration becomes a magnet that attracts things to you. So what you put out is gonna come back to you.
For now, which is cool. But y'all, so we about to, this is what we are strategizing. Not strategizing how we can create families, how we can better our community. We strategizing on how we can lock in as women and, you know, I'm gonna pray.
Feminism has done a horrible number on our community, for sure. And now you're going to try to finish it off, or, you know, much as you can, at least, with this 4B mess. Now, of course, I look at this 4B movement as something that's on the fringe, because one thing I can say that you're not going to stop, at least in the area of, let's say, even Black American women. Black American women still going to date Black American men. They're going to procreate with them. They're still going to, you know, have intimacy with them. They're going to still marry them. So I don't really see this as something that's taking off. But there are people that are just kind of entertaining this. Now, let's call it what it is. Some people are in the quote-unquote 4B movement because a lot of men have said that I'm cool.
Integrity. You want a man who makes a certain amount of money. You want a man who wines and dines you. You want a man that spoils you. You want a man that's sensitive, that cares about your goals and your dreams.
It'd be much cheaper than going out on certain dates. Now, that's the conversation that they should have, because a lot of men have taken themselves out of the dating market. It's not really the other way around. Let's be real about that. Some men have got their passports, and some men have, you know, went overseas and started, you know, trying to find, you know, maybe some love overseas. But it is not something that I really see taking off a lot. So don't let this TikTok so-called 4B movement thinking that's going to do anything when that's not even the majority of South Korean women is doing things. Y'all just always looking to something to try to harm yourself, because this decentering men thing, that's a luxury of the Western world, because you don't, a lot is not put on you. Let's call it what it is. You go look at that bridge in Baltimore right now. It's not a bunch of women that's trying to hurry up and get that bridge, the salvage. Let's try to get this bridge going and this bridge rebuilt. It is a bunch of men who's doing that. So if men truly were decentered and men truly said, okay, fine, y'all got it, you can handle society, American society, Western society will crumble overnight, because women do not maintain the society that way. It is men that maintain society. If you look at the pandemic, when that happened, when they shut everything down, who was working? Men. The majority of women did not work because their jobs was not essential to keep the country going. You understand what I'm saying? So that's why when I see so-called movements like this, I just think it's quite funny, because when you see when the rubber really meets the road, when natural disasters happen, pandemics happen, or whatever, all of a sudden now you need men. So if they want to do a 4B, hey, let them have at it, fellas. Tell them God bless them. I hope you get everything you need from it.
I need that type of man. You see, he's going to have a few requirements of his own. Because when a man builds himself up and has himself in a position where he can do all of this for you, and he's together emotionally and mentally, maybe even physically.
So once you're on that vibration of celebrating yourself, the bitches that's going to tolerate you are going to run from you. Because you're not going to attract them, you're going to repel them.
Be careful what you ask for, because the man that's emotionally intelligent, he knows when to cut somebody off who's taking him for granted. He's self-aware, and he uses his spirit of discernment.
Already done checked out. A large number of men already done checked out and went somewhere else. So you don't have to act like you missed a get bad by starting a movement, desensitizing men. Because at the end of the day, you're going to need men. Your roles and your fingers can only get you so far. But see, that's the reality. The reality is women need men. Men need women. We both need each other.
Make me sick. No, I'm sick of, man, let me tell you something. I'm telling you this. I said what you're scared to say. I can tell you.
It's not like how it was back in the 90s for dating and relationships. It was fun back in the 90s. But now, so much has shifted. It's sad. Until then, go be the best you can possibly be. Live your life, men. Continue to use wisdom. Success is yours. One.
Don't mess with the way you are, gonna see a million. We got the Congo long, just like the Amazon. Split big like a cylinder, man, I'll beat like God.